Keeping in line with the reopening story, commodity prices have surged as demand for everything from oil and lumber to soybeans, sugar, and even rubber is ramping up big time. Tom, sticking with you, how big of a red flag is inflation right now?
We are surveying advisors every week, and since last fall, they were really concerned about inflation, especially as we started to see rates creep up a bit. But home prices, food prices, gas prices, commodity prices, right through the whole landscape, we're starting to see increases there, which are fairly concerning. And this is the first time in not 10 years, but almost 20 years, where we've started to see these types of spikes. So there's a couple ETFs out there I wanted to bring to the surface. One in particular was the Direction Auspice Broad Commodity Strategy. And when you talk about active management, what they do is they break down 12 different commodities and basically use them on a trend following technique where those that are above their trend lines, they buy. Those that are below their trend lines recently, like gold and natural gas that has not been keeping up with other commodities, actually does pretty well. So the ticker there is COM. And then the biggest diversified commodity ETF is by Invesco, PDBC, that if you just want a basket of commodities futures and you don't have to worry about it, that's something to consider. Both don't have the hassle of K-1s, which has been a concern over time with commodity-based ETF strategies.
Fascinating. Steve, what's the inflation prospect look like to you from the standpoint of growth versus value? We talked about that a little bit with regard to the reopening trade. But what about with regard to inflation?
So when you look at the 10-year, everyone got spooked. The growth sector got spooked because we spiked to about 1.75 in the 10-year. And then it leveled off. I think, Leslie, we're almost in a Goldilocks environment. I know that everyone is looking for rates to spike higher, and maybe they will eventually. But you have Chair Powell sitting on rates. You have the 10-year just sort of sitting out there in this sweet spot where growth and value can actually perform. Obviously, in the commodities that you're talking about, lumber, just the chart looks incredibly bullish. That has to give it up. Sometime soon, but it's not hurt the builders. So far, we've seen D.R. Horton up 35%, 45% year to date, Lennar up 35%, Pulte up 25%. So when I'm looking at my value basket, I look at globally represented value names, not just domestic. I do think that the home builders will move sideways to lower because they are so domestic facing.
Mark, I read in the producer's notes that you believe the saying sell in May and go away might actually apply to 2021. We are on the cusp of May. I think it's about next week. Why do you believe that? What are some of the warning signals out there that make you think that it could be a good idea to take some money off the table these days?
Yeah, look, we had just an unbelievable Q1 in just about everything that could be priced. Lumber prices, home prices. Home prices went up quarter over quarter, the highest in the history of the index, 18% in one quarter. So we've gotten over ebullient. Oil prices are up 100% year over year. Everything went up a lot. Copper prices are exploding. And I think all of that's going to come through inflation here in Q2. I think the inflation numbers are going to spook people a lot. And I think, if you think about the reason sell in May and go away exists is if you hold from May till October, you usually lose a little bit of money. You make all your money in a normal year on the tail ends on the other sides. And I think that spike in inflation, a spooking, again, a jump back in interest rates are going to get people to sell off the high growth stocks. And then on top of it, we got the threat of higher capital gains taxes. That'll exacerbate the problem. So I can see a big rotation, growth to value, and there will be places to hide. But generally speaking, I think the markets will be pretty volatile through the summer and into the fall. And you're just better off to raise some cash, kind of sit it out, and then buy some things on sale in the fall.
Notoriously a period of lower liquidity, as well as a lot of people decide to check out in August, another time periods to go on vacation. So it would make sense that we could see some additional volatility over the summer.